Hello to another design challenge. In this challenge, we're gonna be using Blender and we're gonna try to make these mushroom-shaped lamp. The idea is to 3D print it. Now, it's basically just two pieces. This first piece, which is the base, and the second piece, which is the shade. The idea is to 3D print it with translucent plastics. So this, although it may look like a monster, the idea is to create these, the idea is to have the base have, or design the base to have these like supports for the top part, for the shade. And in the base as well, add these like tunnel shape and these like top part, well, the socket, which I have right here. This one, go to one side. This one right here. So the here's where the light bulb goes. This is one of the light bulbs I'm using to test this out. And I'm gonna be measuring it to get a sense of dimensions. But yeah, so okay, let's get started. As I said, we're gonna be using Blender. In this corner right here, you're gonna be able to see what I'm clicking. Like that. Actually, let me just do it a bit bigger. I think, and lower right about here. I think that's good. Maybe the mouse just a bit bigger. Yeah, that's good. All right. So okay, I'm gonna select everything. I'm gonna delete everything. I could use the picture as a reference for the shape, but I'm not gonna do that in this tutorial. I'm just gonna like eyeball it. All right, I think the first thing I wanna do is to 3D model the components I have just to get a sense of the shape before I even 3D model everything else. So let me just get a sense of the shape of this. I'll be back with you in a minute. I'm gonna take some measurements. All right, so I changed my mind. And, you know, I could 3D model the socket in Blender. I could actually do it, but I'm thinking it's gonna be way easier if I 3D model it in a parametric software. Yeah, I think that's gonna be way easier. Yeah, all right. So, actually, you know what? I think I'm going to, no. I'm thinking too much. You know what? No, everything in Blender. Yeah, why not? All right. So first things first, I'm going to, shift A, shift A. Oh, there it is. Cylinder. Now, when you model in Blender, 3D model in Blender, the dimensions you see here, are always gonna be millimeters when you export it. Now this is gonna be for 3D printing. If we were not 3D printing it, I wouldn't care at all. But since it's gonna be 3D printed, I do care. So let's see, our socket, let's get the general diameter of the socket. I mean, well, not the outermost, but at least the upper part is 32.25. So I'm gonna do 32.25. And then here, 32.25, awesome. And then I'm gonna go all the way down up until here. That's 50.48. I'm being way too precise. 50.48. Now, of course, if you're gonna have a different, like, what's the word, socket, please measure your socket. Now I'm gonna enter edit mode, Control R. Oh, so something I have to tell you is that I am using Blender. The presets I'm using are 27x. If you're new to Blender, you're probably using Blender, which is 2.8 and over. You just have to look for the translation of what I'm doing, but many things are probably the same, and I'm gonna try to call them out, like the names of the things, for people to be able to look with the translation into shortcut and stuff. All right, well, now I'm gonna measure this like little belt that it has. So let's see how much more big is that. 39, the diameter, 39.2. 39.2. So I'm gonna go here, Control R, 1, 2. I'm gonna eyeball it here. I'm gonna actually scale in Z. I think it's, I'm gonna be more precise. Don't worry. Actually, before I even, I'm gonna check the distance. Yeah. Actually, I don't have to be that precise. I don't have to. Anyway, I think I'll end up being. So it's the thickness of the belt is 10.84. 10.84, so I'm gonna going to etch, shift alt, through the whole thing, grabbing Z. I'm gonna turn on snapping with vertices, grabbing Z, and snap it here, grab in Z, 10.84. Now, something you have to know is that Blender is not the best software for making precise measurements. I am doing it anyway, but it's not the best software. That's what I was thinking, maybe using Onshape and then exporting the model and putting it here, but it was too much work around, and probably if you're looking at this tutorial, you wanna learn Blender, so why not? Grabbing Z, I'm gonna put it here. Now I'm gonna bring it down. How much down? Well, it depends on your socket. My socket is 26. Grab in Z, 26 negative. There we go. Now, I'm gonna X, okay, so I'm gonna, faces, there you go, extrude, but then, okay, I'm gonna turn off the snap, scale, shift Z, and I'm gonna bring it out. How much out? Well, I don't like doing it this way, but that's, I think, the way I know. So it's 38.8, so I'm just gonna like go out into the general dimensions, and I'm right now I'm 35. I need to reach 38.83. So scale, GC, just a bit more. It's not the best way. 38. Okay, almost there. 6. Too much. If you want a more precise handle, you can turn your put your mouth far there. Too much. Oh, got it. Not the best way of doing something. Definitely not the best way. But anyway. Shift Alt, select the whole thing. Now I'm gonna scale in Z. Whoop. Now I'm gonna grab this whole thing. Control B to make a bevel. Using the wheel for the mouse. Oh, I think that's accurate. I mean, check the shape. That's pretty much it, right? Yeah, you're probably thinking like, of course. I don't know. 17.65 is the diameter of the protruding thing that I got down here. 17.65. Something I can do is I can go to this face, Shift S, cursor to selected, Shift A, cylinder. No. Command Z. Get out. Shift A. Mesh cylinder, 1765. Now it's I'm gonna use the lower part. I'm always glad when I can use like the lower part of the caliper. Like so many, so I think a few people know that This is used to measure like depth. 8.18. And I think, well, I mean, of course it depends on what's the kind of thing you do. If you use it often or not. But in my case, I don't use it that often. So I just delete that face. I'm gonna join them now. Control J. Now I'm gonna go inside this thingy. I'm gonna select this face, delete it, and now I'm just gonna unify these two things. Boom, boom. And then open the menu. Now this menu, I don't know yet how to open it in Blender 2.8. I haven't looked for it. Let me just check it for you, in the case you'll need that. Open search Blender 2.8. F3. All right. Apparently that's it. Spacebar. I use a spacebar, but that's because I'm using lower version. Anyway, you'll find it, I'm sure. I'm gonna look for bridge edge loops. There you go. So I got the socket. Good. Yeah, that's good. All right. Now I need the light bulb. All right, light bulb. It's this one right here. You find your own and draw it, of course. I mean, take the measurements. All right. Caliper in 0. Let's measure the total diameter of, like, this top sphere. In this case, it's, like, a pretty much a sphere, but depends on, like, your light bulb. 59.79. Okay. Shift A, mesh sphere. 59.39. Grabbing Z. Okay, grabbing Z. All right, now I'm gonna measure the total. I mean, not a total, but at least what I need, which is like if you put them together. Up until the point they connect. Okay, if someone in the commentary knows what kind of music I'm listening to, you get an extra point. The comments, I mean. So I think this is, All right. This is not the way of doing it. At least not the best way. Actually, I'm just gonna use like these faces right here. Box. Yep. Scale Z 0. Grab in Z. Yeah, I mean just a bit smaller. Alright. 85. Almost there. 86. This is not the best way. All right. So there's a better way, actually. I can just grab these vertex. Let's see. One. I could duplicate that vertex in Z. -89.59. All right. Now I can B grab Z and then snap it there. That's one way. Yeah, that was. Alright, and then I can delete that vertex. Alright, so that's not the best light bulb ever. But I think it can be corrected. Control R. Kind of like there, like in the middle actually. Scale. Control B. No. I think I can do this whole thing. Grabbing Z. Yeah. Yeah, that's way better. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm being too perfectionist right now. That's not good. Control B. No need for this. No need. No. Grabbing Z. Grabbing Z. All right. There you go. So that's okay. Yeah. Got it. Yeah. That's my light bulb and my socket. Grabbing Z. Now I can model everything else, right? So Shift C, Shift A. Let's make the base curve. The curve always appears on the top. Like you can see the curve in two dimensions, but always. No, maybe I'm wrong. No, yeah, I was right. Yeah. You always see it from the top view. Check it out. Yeah, you see the curve now? The top view. So, I'm going to rotate it in X 90 degrees. Now it's standing, right? Rotate it in Y minus 90. Grab in Z. Now, as you can see, if I go into edit mode, you have nodes and you have the handlers. I'm gonna make sure the initial and ending node stays within. Well, actually, that's not that much needed. Anyway, all right, yeah, just make sure they stay within the same the X0. X0, where they are, location, yeah. And you may be thinking, like, why is it a 1 here? Well, because it was rotated. Like, originally, this guy was in 1, right? Well, it was in, I think, 0.5 when it started, when he was born. So, because I rotated it, this is pretty messed up. Like, it's supposed to be growing in Z, and it says here X. Like, what the heck? So, I'm gonna just... You have to apply the transformations you did. So I'm going to do that with Control A. Oh, no, that's not. Command A. Yeah. Command A, location. I'm going to apply all transformations because why not? And then I'm going to grab the whole. Actually, I'm going to do that again. So I'm going to scale the whole curve into something more manageable. Actually, until the socket, just until it reaches the socket, kind of like there. And then I'm going to apply again. Apply all transformations. Good. Now I can work with this. Actually, I'm going to make it just a bit smaller. Change my mind. Sorry. I changed my mind a lot. I'm so sorry. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Now, okay, apply all transformations again. Now, yeah, now I'm going to select these two things. I need more nodes. So I'm going to select these two nodes. W, subdivide. And now I have this one. Check that out. Grabbing Z. Now, if you want a line to be like for these two nodes, to be like straight, you can use V, vector, and you get a straight line. You can use a snap as well. Grabbing Z and then snap it. That's cool. Grabbing X. Good. I like it. Actually, I'm not going to go that precise here. Although I'm going to make more notes. W, subdivide. There's now a new one here. And just grab this one. True enough. There it is. You may not know what I'm doing. Because I haven't explained it. What I'm doing right now is Sorry, clear frame. Actually, I like that frame. Maybe another one there. I am drawing this shape, whatever the socket is there, so I can revolve it and create a three-dimensional revolved shape, right? With the hole fit in to put a socket. So that's why I'm drawing just half of it and taking care the hole for the socket is there. All right, no more talking. Double use of divide. Grab. Yeah, why not? Grabbing Z. I'm gonna grab an X. Snap with this one. Now I need another one. Well, I mean, I can use this handler and move it. Oh, look at that. I think can you see it now? I think I do need another node though. Between these two, W, subdivide. I want these to be automatic. Just all curve. Yep, just like that. Graph. I'm gonna make it like same size, and then from the middle, scale it. That's more proportionate. That's more like it. What happened here anyway? Oh, that's weird. Okay, so I'm gonna grab this one. Oh, no. Grab this handle. Grab. And then scale Z0. I'm gonna put it in Z0. I'm gonna make sure it's flat. And maybe I can do that with this one right here. Yeah, I'm gonna cut it at the end. I think it's hard to make it flat with a curve, so. All right, from these, actually this is really nice. Anyway, one more. Subdivide, V automatic, grab. Yeah, why not? All right. Okay, so originally it was supposed to be salsa music, but now I don't know what the heck is this. Sounds like a really tropical jazz. Like that, yeah, it looks nice. I want this to be more accentuated, yeah. Although, you do need no, actually, I don't need to connect them, they can be open. So, something really important is that the origin of the object has to stay in the center. I mean, it doesn't have to, but it's nice to have. And then, I'm gonna go here, add modifier, screw. Oh, that was fast. That's too pointy right there. That's why you see it like that. So maybe I need a bit of like some thickness to it. Edit mode here and here. W subdivide and then this one. Grab it and put it. Oh wait, what? And this. Okay, this and this V vector. Grab in Z. There you go. Grabbing next. Grab. Alright. Yeah, why not? Alright. I like it. Ooh. Okay. This is just looking weird. I think there's a way of making it not look weird. But I just forgot. How was it? Was it object? Oh. Shape flat. No. Shade smooth? No. It was one of those. Maybe it's looking weird. I think yeah, it's looking weird because when I zoom out, that happens. Actually, that can be repaired just here in view. And just add some zeros to it. There you go. Okay, didn't help. Oh, look. I think there it is. I'm gonna change. I don't know what this is. I just play with it and something works. Alright, I think that's better. And now the screw, actually the curve within itself has some like, what's the word? Like divisions to it, right? So the curve, actually, anyway, I don't know if the curve can be saved from that if I already started with it. So let's avoid it. Let's not think about that. What I can change right now, and I know I can change it, well, what I know I can change right now is the number of steps here to make it look like super smooth. So instead of 36, sorry, 16, 32. Let me get a pill to numb my throat. All right. I need 1 second. All right, I'm back. Now what we need, I have this cable wire. It's the one that we use for the lamp. I'm gonna measure it, and we're gonna make it like a space for the wire to get out. So, let's measure this. I think, well, actually the wire is like 7, but I'm gonna go wider. I'm gonna go like 9. 9. Sounds like German. 9. Yeah, 9. All right, 9. So, there are several ways of doing that, I think. Okay, so first, what I need to do is, let's see, from here, Shift A, mesh cube, make it bigger, grab in Z, and like here, no, maybe more stability, like here, more stability, like here, yeah, right, here, all right, here, I'm gonna create a new collection. Actually, okay, let's name this stuff. What's your name? Your name is gonna be base. What's your name? Light bulb. What's your name? Now that's also music. New collection. I'm gonna call this collection mutts. Cube is gonna be called base bottom cut. I'm gonna put it inside mutts. Mutts, I'm gonna turn the eye off. Little base is gonna be cut. Boolean. Oh, I cannot do a boolean because it's not a mesh yet. So base, I'm gonna call you base curve. And then I'm gonna create a new collection called backup. And so I'm gonna duplicate base curve. I'll put this one here too. Base curve. And this one, the one and backup, I'm gonna turn it off as well. Now this one right here, the base curve, I'm gonna call it now base mesh. I'm gonna do Alt C, convert to mesh. Now this is not a curve anymore, this is a mesh, so I cannot modify it like I used to with the curve. It's not related to the curve anymore. I'm gonna go to Boolean, difference, base bottom cut, so now it's that. That's not good though. Let's see if fast make it better. Yeah, that's better. That's the hole I needed. I mean, the cut I needed. All right. Now here, I'm gonna make now the cut for for the cable. So shift C, shift A. I'm gonna do it pretty basic. Cylinder 9 by 9, and then scaling Z like a lot. Grabbing Z, scaling Z. It's gonna be called yeah. All right, shift D, rotate in Y90, grab, and I'm just gonna put it here. Oh well, I could just. So right now it's 210 in Z. Let me do 200. Why would you make it a round number, Francisco? So I can be grab in X 100, and it's right on the half. Let's see if that helps anyway. I'm gonna go a bit lower though. When I see it from the side, that's the cut you'll see. Unless it looks cooler if I go like that. Actually, this does not have to be precise at all. I'm taking way too much time here. All right, so this is called, let's call this vertical cut. And let's call this horizontal cut. And I'll, these two, I'm gonna set them to mods. This boolean difference vertical cut. Oh, there you go. And then I'm gonna duplicate it. Horizontal cut. Doesn't want to comply, huh? All right. I'm thinking there's some issues with these. Let's see. I think there's the issue right there. If I select the central vertex, only 1 by 1 is being selected. That means it's not fully like joined. So I'm gonna just use, I'm gonna deselect everything. C, select all the vertices. I think it's Alt M. No. Control M. No. Shift M. No. Command M. No. All right, vertex mesh merge at center. There you go. So now if I select one vertex, there's only one actually, and I can move it along. I think that's, I mean, that and maybe same problem at the top where my curve started. Oh, same issue. All right, so the way to repair that is just same thing. Getting closer. A, Z, C, I mean C as in celery. how was it? Mesh, merge, center. There you go. All right, now the first hole works now. The second one, oh good. Oh wait, what? That's not good. What a mess. Oh, there you go. Now every cut has to be exact. That's the way to do it. I know, it doesn't look nice at all. But yeah, that's what we have. I'm pretty sure it's just how it looks. Oh, that's way better. I mean, people may argue it doesn't look nice. I like it. Like it better. All right, that's a cut, that's it. All right, oh, all right, so I have stuff to do. I'll be back and we'll be working on the top part. Oh, that's half an hour. Okay, so we're gonna stop here. Next tutorial, I'm gonna do the support. No, you know what? First, I'm going to do the shade and then the support, so it's related. All right, see you in the next one.